As we move towards the ending of this program, I would like to say that even though it's a day event, but tourism is something you can't describe in a day or two. It's an experience which I can't tell you. And even if you tell me, I won't be able to understand, because you can put your journey into beautiful words, but only the traveler knows the true vibe.
That's true. Each journey has a different and one-time experience, which you can't put into words. And we are proud to be a part of Jagran Lake City University, especially the School of Hospitality and Tourism family. And in this auspicious day, I would like to wish you all a very happy World Tourism Day. Now, for the valedictory ceremony, I would like to call upon our Associate Dean, Faculty of Applied Sciences and Technology, and Director of School of Hospitality and Tourism, Dr. Raj Kumar Gupta, to please come on the dais and give away the welcome address.
A very good afternoon to everyone. Today, we must say that this is an achievement for our students and the faculty members of School of Hospitality and Tourism. The reason is that this is the first event in the session, and after almost 18 months of pandemic, we are able to do partly online and partly offline. So I must compliment all those students and faculty members. And now we are coming to the end after having the guest speakers, panel discussions, the beautiful stalls put up in the canteen area. We are coming to close the event. And who else? Who could be the better person to give away the prizes and bless us? Our own registrar, sir. Sir, I welcome you here for the valedictory function and give away the prizes. Before we go further, I must say that this event, the competition, the speaker in the beginning, Mr. P.P. Kharna, he is the president of India Domestic Tour Operators of India, and he spoke such a beautiful words about the industry and about the students. We are certainly enriched by his words of wisdom. Then panel discussions, and purposely keeping in mind the theme of the event, theme of the day, we invited the people from diverse fields directly or indirectly related to the tourism. And after that, you know, the students have put up so many stalls and of the handicrafts, food stalls, etc. And really they are, you know, selling the delicious dishes there. The event in the competition, we have received entries, not from India, but from abroad. I am told that we have received entries from as far as Toronto, Canada, Dubai, Malaysia. And if you just talk about India, we have received entries from Bhubaneswar, Odisha, Pune, Maharashtra, Hamirpur from Himachal, Chandigarh, or Varanasi, Punjab, Delhi, UP, and of course from Madhya Pradesh. So that's, I'm very sure the judges have very tough competition to decide who is the winner. So I'm not taking so much time. Thank you very much, sir. I welcome you here for the valedictory function. Thanks, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving us this opportunity of celebrating this event offline and for the first time online, keeping all the protocols of COVID as well. We have organized the stalls in our campus. Now, with immense pleasure, would like to welcome our chief guest, Professor Dr. Vivek Khare, sir, Registrar, Jagran Lake City University, and patron, Conventus 2021. Professor Dr. Vivek Khare, sir, who is well-known personality in academia and sports, his research on problems of recovery and overuse of loans with special reference to Madhya Pradesh State Financial Corporation and Madhya Pradesh Audyog Vikas Nigam, was well appreciated and got awarded as his PhD thesis in the year 2003. He has a wide experience of teaching, administration, and research for about 2.5 decades. His area of specialization includes accounting and finance. He is equally competent in commerce and management education also. He is the member of the interview panel of some prominent banks, Government of Madhya Pradesh and AIMA. He also supervises the KPMG Accounting Practices, KCAP, and CIMA courses. Professor Dr. Vivek Khare also serves as a consultant, board of studies member, and visiting faculty in some of the prominent institutions of Madhya Pradesh, and also is an active member of the Indian Commerce Association. Sir, with great pleasure, we would like to invite you to give away the welcome address.
Thank you. You are the chief guest in your own institution. That is, thank you, sir. First of all, a very happy World Tourism Day to all of you. And for organizing this particular event, I would like to congratulate Dr. Gupta, Dr. Shoaib, Anant, Hamilton, Chef Devakar, and all the faculty members for organizing this event and inviting me. I'm sorry I was not able to join you in the morning because of some of my official duties. First of all, I was listening to Vice Chancellor online. Everyone was talking about the domestic tourism, and I'm not going into the details of all this thing because you people are listening all the things since morning. And I just remember ki dekho apna desh was the slogan given by the Government of India on 25th of January when we are celebrating our Indian Tourism Day, I think. So that is, we people should understand, because of the pandemic also and the world, your UN WTO as last year and their analysis has mentioned that 84% tourism was dropped last year during March and November due to pandemic. But again, as the speakers were mentioning since morning, that now the days are coming, the people are traveling now. People have started traveling. And today itself in the Dainik Bhaskar, I was reading that in the weekends, the people are going for some destinations or for some, for say sort of a change of their, from their routines. And we all know that, in India, I always often speak to this people that when we talk about the tourism in India, the most important what I feel is the religious tourism and the spiritual tourism nowadays. A religious tourism, everyone knows that. And why I have raised this issue? Because when we talk about the religious tourism, there are a number of things are related to the religious tourism in India. You talk about any of the yatras in India, maybe a Chardham Yatra or Amarnath Yatra or maybe Vaishno Devi, you will find number of people are getting jobs of all these things. You talk about Amarnath Yatra, the Pittu people will get some amount. You talk about Vaishno Devi, the people who are associated with the small dhabas from Jammu to Katra and whatever. You will find the people are getting jobs because of this religious tourism also. And with the religious tourism, people may plan the tourism in Kashmir also. This is happening in India. So when this industry was affected during pandemic, we have seen that number of people were get unemployed because of all these reasons. When the tourism will start with this all religious tourism in India or a spiritual tourism like McLeodganj and other places where the people of any caste or any religions are going for the tourism purpose, the tourism industry will again come out. And I'm sure that people may talk about this in pandemic. It was the most affected industry, but at the same time, it will come like anything. In coming days, this industry will again grow up, and the people now fed up with all these lockdowns and other things for last 2 years. Now the people are coming out of the thing. Earlier, the people were not going outside the, say, Bhopal se paas chale gaye zora sa utna ja rahe the, but now people are traveling, not only in Madhya Pradesh, they are traveling to across India. So this is how the tourism industry will grow. And as World Tourism, United Nations have already given the name as inclusive growth. So we should understand, and the students should understand this hospitality and tourism students especially should understand that this tourism industry or the hospitality industry will never go down. Maybe sometime thoda sa aisa lagta hai ki piche ho rahe hain, but it will always flourish. So your future is bright. Don't think ki what will happen with our future. You will again shine. And as VC sir has also mentioned, I always believe that every tunnel at the end, there is some light. And the light will definitely will be the bright light. After every dark night, there will be a sunrise. So I am hoping for that sunrise. Of course, sun has to slowly started coming out, but it will be a bright, sunny days will come. And all the best to the students of my hospitality schools. Some faces I remember from first year, and after 2 years, I saw these faces. So best of luck for your future. And thank you, Dr. Gupta and team, for inviting me. And now I think already I have spoken much, because I know the people who are the winner will like to have the prizes first. So all the best and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your enlightening words. I guess you remember me from the first year. Yes, sir. So moving ahead. डुबकियां सिंधु में गोताखोर लगाता है, जा जाकर खाली हाथ लौट कर आता है, मिलता नहीं सहज ही मोती भर पानी में, बढ़ता उत्साह इसी हैरानी में, मुट्ठी उसकी खाली हर बार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती. As we move forward towards the end of this amazing event, I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to each one of you present here for making this event a success.
So now, moving forward, I wish to quote Anne Frank, "Whoever is happy will make others happy too." And we, the organizers, are so happy just because of you people. So ab aapko khush karna bhi to hamari zimmedari hai, boss. Now, it's time to know the categories and which were the for the competition.
It's a beautiful world. Why not capture and record some moments of it? So the first category in prizes we have is for Flutter the Shutter, in which students have showcased their photography and videography skills as well. For the second category, we had Assorted Arts, in which we had painting and sketching. It's good to let your inner Pablo Picasso work sometimes. Last but not the least, we had Being Vocal, in which we had audio making as well. We were overwhelmed by the entries, and it's not that we've received entries from across the country, but also places like Dubai, Toronto, etc. So all these entries were judged by the renowned personalities and experts of the field. Winning doesn't always mean being first. Winning means you're doing better than you've ever done before. And I can assure you that our first runner-ups will be more polished than the second next event and will give you a tough competition to your winners.
Congratulations. Now, moving forward with the words of Mr. Perfectionist. अगर सिल्वर जीतती तो आज नहीं तो कल तन्ने लोग भूल ही जावेंगे.
पर हम और ये कॉन्वेंटस 2021 कभी नहीं भूलेगा, ना ही अपने विनर्स को और ना कि पार्टिसिपेंट्स को भी. सो सब याद रहेंगे इस कॉन्वेंटस 21 को.
आई कॉपी दैट. लेकिन गोल्ड जीतने वाले तो मिसालें बन जाते हैं, और मिसालें दी नहीं जाती बेटा, भूली भी नहीं जाती.
Now, I would request Honorable Registrar Sir to give away the prizes of the winners. I would like to call upon our Director Sir to accompany him. Please, sir. Come, start. First, we have the video competition. So the first winner is in the category of graduation category. So it's Huzaifa Zafar from Malaysia. Thank you so much, Josefa. Seriously, that was a video to watch. So the first winner in the 10th and below category is Shambhavi Singh from BHEC Bhopal. On behalf of that, I would like to ask Pranav to come on the stage and take away the prize. Second comes the sketching competition. So we have a very nice prize to give away. So the youngest sketch artist, who is 6 years old, I would like to call upon Arnold Hamilton to get the prize for sketching. Arnold परेशान लग रहे हैं थोड़े. Yeah. So the first winner from the graduation category goes to Ayush Sharma from Haryana. On behalf of that, I would like to ask Pranav to please come and take away the prize. So now for the first winner for post-graduation category, I would like to call upon Shivang Saxena from Pune. On behalf of that, I would like to ask Elbin to come up and take away the prize. So the certificates will be posted at your postal address as well. So don't worry, you will be getting your certificates. Please, yeah. So next we have Being Vocal audio clip competition. So the first winner from the graduation category is Srishti Jain from Bhopal. A huge round of applause for Srishti, our Jagan University student. Next, we have the first winner in the 10th standard and below category, Ms. Nishtha Agarwal from Bareilly, Uttar Pradesh. I would like to ask Vartika to please come up and take away the certificate. Next, we have the painting competition. So the first winner in the 10th standard and below category is Nishant Agarwal from Bareilly, Uttar Pradesh. I would like to ask Mr. Pranav, so please come and take away the prize. So the next winner from graduation category is Diksha Shikre from Bhopal. I would like to ask Vartika to please come up and take away the prize. Now we had the first winner from post-graduation category, Ms. Aparna Goyal from New Delhi. So on behalf of her, I would like to ask Vartika to please come up and take away the prize. Now we had photography competition. So for the first winner, I would like to call upon from graduation category, I would ask Kunal Maheshwari from Bhopal to please come. Please come. Now the first winner from the post-graduation category, we would like to call upon Sunny Kumar Chaurasia from post-graduation from BHU Varanasi. On behalf of him, I would like to ask Shubham to come and take away the prize. Next we have for 10th standard and below category, Mr. Suvan Mohan Gupta from Montreal, Canada. So I would like to call upon Sir, please Shradhang, please come and take away the prize. Next, we have for 10th to 12th standard category, we have Varnika Gupta from New Delhi as the first winner. So I would like to call upon, on behalf of her, Ms. Tayyaba to please come and take away her prize. Last but not the least, we have the other category from Kolkata. We like to call upon Ms. Bihan Banerjee for the first winner prize. So please, I would like to call upon Shubham to take away his prize. Round of applause for all the winners. Please put on your videos on. I would like to see all of you clapping to all the winners as there. Thank you so much, everyone, joining us virtually and physically as well. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks to all the members who are there. So now, last but not the least, I would request Conventus Convener 2021 Coordinator and Assistant Professor of Jagran Lake City University School of Hospitality and Tourism, Ms. Meghna Raizada Ma'am, to come upon the dais and give away the vote of thanks. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Fez. The best and most beautiful thing in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt with the heart. Today, I'm feeling so grateful and would like to express my gratitude to each one of you. To begin with, word of thanks, I would first like to thank our Honorable Chancellor, Sir of Jagran Lake City University, Sri Hari Mohan Gupta, Sir, for the encouragement and continuous guidance. I would like to express my sincere thanks to our Honorable Pro-Chancellor, Sir, Sri Abhishek Mohan Gupta, Sir, for giving us the opportunity to conduct this event and for being a constant support and guide. Moving forward, I would like to thank our Vice-Chancellor, Sir, for giving us this opportunity to go further with this event offline and was along with us for the inaugural ceremony. Again, further, I would like to thank our registrar, sir, Dr. Professor Vivek Khare, sir, for the expert advice and guidance he has given to us and for sparing time with us for the valedictory ceremony. Now, I would like to thank the driving force behind the event, Director of Jagran Lake City University School of Hospitality and Tourism, Dr. Professor Rajkumar Gupta, sir, for this support. I would like to thank Team Lake City Voice, IP Radio for Jagran Lake City University for being our helping hand and radio partners. I would also like to thank Director JLU School of Tourism and Communication, Professor Dr. Divakar Shukla, sir, for his support. I would also like to thank the PCR team and the technical team for arranging all the technical stuff. At last, but not the least, I would like to thank the JLU School of Hospitality and Tourism as a team, we worked. All the students who have been like a pillar 24/7 running around for this event to be this successful. Thank you and have a good day.
Hello. Thank you so much, madam. Now I request all of you to rise for the national anthem. जो हमारे साथ online जुड़े हुए हैं मैं उनसे भी दरख्वास्त करूंगा कि वो सभी राष्ट्रगान के सम्मान में खड़े हो जाएं।
जनगण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
माता की, भारत माता की, भारत माता की। थैंक यू सो मच एवरीवन, थैंक यू सो मच।